Continue reading the explanation by Blessed Theophylact of the Holy Gospel according to St. Luke. Glory to the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit, now and ever, and unto the ages of ages. Amen. Chapter 11, verses 21 through 26. When a strong man armed keepeth his place, his goods are in peace. But when a stronger than he shall come upon him and overcome him, he taketh from him all his weapons, wherein he trusted, and divideth his spoils. He that is not with me is against me, and he that gathers not with me scatters. When the unclean spirit is gone out of man, he walketh through dry places, seeking rest and finding none. He saith, I will return unto my house whenas I came out. And when he cometh, he findeth it swept and adored. Then goeth he, and taking to him seven other spirits more wicked than himself, and they enter in and dwell there, and the last state of the man is worse than the first. Explanation. There was the Lord says, before my coming a strong man, Satan, who guarded his palace, that is, who captured our human nature and held it with an unshakable grip. But I came who am stronger than he, and overcame the world and the full panoply of Satan's weapons wherein he trusted, that is, all the forms of sin. The sin is the weaponry of the devil, and brandishing these weapons, he made bold and overpowered man. This weaponry of his have I shattered, of whom he found to be sinless, and from that time he has grown weak. And his spoils, namely mankind whom he held as booty, I have snatched from him and divided up, giving each one to an angel to be the man's faithful guardian, so that an angel might have him instead of the demon, who before was tyrannized him, had tyrannized him. Furthermore, what communion do I have with Beelzebub? It is my work to gather together children of God who have been scattered. It is his work to scatter those who have been gathered together. How then can you have such thoughts about me, that I keep a company with Satan? Instead, such thoughts have occurred to you by inspiration of the demons. Once before you had an unclean spirit dwelling in you, when you worshipped the idols and slew the prophets. Then it appeared that this unclean spirit had gone out of you, but now it has returned into its own house, into your souls, together with seven, meaning many other full spirit. In scripture, seven means many. Now this unclean spirit has made your last condition worse than it was before. Before, when you worshipped idols and killed the prophets, you didn't yet insult the Son of God, who appeared clearly in the flesh for your sakes. But when hope of salvation is there for you, now that the Son of God has taken flesh and has worked wonders for you, and you show the same ingratitude and violence. The dry place are the souls of those who are not dank and overgrown swamps, but instead are dry and carefully tended, and hence the spirit of uncleanness finds no rest in them. In souls such as this, the evil one has no place to dwell, and so he has returned to these Jews, and their last condition has become worse than their former state. No longer are there any prophets among them, for they have killed the word. No longer do they have any chrism, for they have crucified the very Christ. Before they had all this, even though they worshipped idols. But now they have sinned against the Son of God and have lost all. Glory to the Father, Son, Holy Spirit, now and ever, and to the ages of ages. Amen.